You're listening to the Quint podcast.
This was the scene at the BJP's headquarters at 11 Ashoka Road in Delhi as Jagat Prakash Nadda was unanimously elected as the party's new president. Nadda succeeds Amit Shah as the BJP's president. Nadda was appointed as the party's working president in May 2019 after Amit Shah became the home minister, and he was formally appointed the BJP's president on 20th January 2020. Shah will now be focusing his efforts completely on his role as home minister while Nadda takes over the reins of the party.
Is kaam ko karne ka jo unhone mauka diya avsar diya iske liye pradesh ki sabhi ikaiyon ko main dhanyawad deta hu.
But Nadda's election to the post of the BJP's party president comes after Amit Shah's very successful run as president and comes at a time when India is gripped by protests. Is his election as the BJP president just the beginning of the challenge ahead of him? And will he be able to fill the void left by Amit Shah in the BJP machine? Let's find out. Welcome to The Big Story, the podcast where we dissect headline-making news. I'm Vishnu Gopinath. I'm joined today by political analyst and commentator Amitabh Tiwari.
Whether he'll be able to come out of the shadow or not also depends upon how the party performs in the next few elections.
And author and senior journalist Nilanjan Mukopadhyay.
Every time that Nadda fails, people would say that, oh, if Amit Shah had been there, the party would not have failed.
Together, we are going to tell you everything you need to know about the BJP's new president, JP Nadda, and what lies in store for him in the coming months. First, let's hear from the BJP's leadership about this move. Here's Union Minister Prakash Javadekar.
सभी कार्यकर्ताओं में देशभर में बहुत उत्साह है क्योंकि वो भी एक आंदोलन के हिस्सा रहे हैं सालों से और महत्वपूर्ण बात यह है कि अन्य पार्टियां एक-एक परिवार की पार्टी होती है हमारी पार्टी ही पूरा एक परिवार जैसे काम करती है.
And the BJP's party chief in Delhi, Manoj Tiwari.
पार्टी ने जो भी निर्णय लिया है उसकी अपनी कुछ सोच ही होगी और इसलिए.
Remember, the Delhi elections are coming up soon, which is bound to be one of the first challenges for Nadda. But we'll be discussing that in detail later. Before we proceed, let's dive into Nadda's past. That'll help us understand why the party selected him as Amit Shah's successor. JP Nadda was born on 2nd December 1960 to Narayan Lal Nadda and Krishna Nadda. After completing school at St. Xavier's in Patna, Nadda got a law degree from Himachal Pradesh University in Shimla as well as a postgraduate degree in political science. He joined the ABVP at the age of 18 as a student leader in 1978, and this is where his tryst with politics began. He'd go on to be elected to the Himachal Pradesh Assembly, first in 1993 and then again in 1998, when he was appointed the Minister of Health and Family Welfare and Parliamentary Affairs. So, his ties to the party go way back, a loyalty that's over 40 years old. Which perhaps gives us the answer to our first question. Why was JP Nadda selected as the party president? I asked senior journalist and author Nilanjan Mukopadhyay.
JP Nadda has been selected because he is very strong loyalist to both Mr. Modi as well as Amit Shah. He would, the relations between Mr. Modi and Amit and JP Nadda go back to the 90s. So they've had a long association. And I guess Mr. Nadda's name did come up to be a possible president in 2014. At that point, eventually Mr. Amit Shah edged his way up and became the president. So when there was a vacancy, they went back to Mr. Nadda, who was in any case in the reckoning at that point. And it does not in any way disturb the hierarchy within the government and the party. He's a loyalist. So there will be no attempt on part of Mr. Nadda to, you know, for the party organization to work at cross purposes with the government. So there will not be any conflict of interest between the government and party, which used to happen quite often when Mr. Vajpayee was the Prime Minister, and the party had on several occasions were at odds with Mr. Vajpayee and the government.
Want to hear the rest of this podcast? Check out the link to the full episode in the description below and follow The Quint on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, JioSaavn, and all other platforms we are on.